Learning outcomes. Creation and understanding of Azure Resource Group. Creation and understanding of Azure Virtual Machine. Creation and understanding of Azure Service Principle. What is a resource group? A resource group is a container that holds related resources of an Azure cloud. The resource group can include those resources that you want to manage as a group. It is resource creator's decision how he want to allocate resources to resource groups. Generally, it is good to add resources that share the same lifecycle to the same resource group so you can easily deploy, update, and delete them as a group. The resource group stores metadata about the resources. Therefore, specifying a location for the resource group, we are specifying where that metadata is stored. For compliance reasons, we may need to ensure that data is stored in a particular region. Steps to create resource groups. Sign in to the Azure portal. Select resource groups. Select Create. Enter the following values. Subscription. Select your Azure subscription. Resource group. Enter a new resource group name Learning Docker. Region. Select an Azure location, such as East US. Select Review plus Create. Select Create. It takes a few seconds to create a resource group. Select Refresh from the top menu to refresh the resource group list, and then select the newly created resource group to open it. Or select Notification, the bell icon, from the top, and then select Go to Resource Group to open the newly created resource group. How to create an Ubuntu virtual machine in Azure Portal. Azure Virtual Machines, VMs, can be created through the Azure Portal. This method provides a browser-based user interface to create VMs and their associated resources. This quick start shows how to use the Azure Portal to deploy a virtual machine, VM, in Azure that runs Ubuntu Server 20.04 LTS Gen 2. To see your VM in action, you can use SSH login to the VM using Git Bash, then update the virtual machine and install Azure CLI. Type free in search box. Select free services. Select Linux virtual machine, then click create. Create a virtual machine page opens. In the Basics tab, under Project Details, make sure the correct subscription is selected and then choose to resource group we created earlier, or you can create new resource group if you wish. Select Learning Docker from drop-down. Under Instance Details, type Docker machine for the virtual machine name and choose Region, East US. Security type, standard. Image. Click, see all images. Then select Ubuntu Server 20.04 LTS, Gen 2 for the image. Leave the other defaults. Under Administrator Account, provide a username, such as Azure User and a password, and confirm password. Notes: the password must be at least 12 characters long and meet the defined complexity requirements. Under Inbound Port Rules, choose Allow Selected Ports and then select SSH 22 and HTTP 80 from the drop-down. Leave the remaining defaults and then select the Review plus Create button at the bottom of the page. After validation runs, select the Create button at the bottom of the page. After deployment is complete, select Go to Resource. How to connect to virtual machine. Create a remote, SSH, connection to the virtual machine. These directions tell you how to connect to your VM from a Windows computer. On the overview page for your virtual machine, copy public IP. Open your local Git bash. Then type command SSH Azure user at public IP. In our case, it is 52.249.188.70, and press enter. It will ask for ED25519 fingerprint key. Type yes. Then enter password created during creation of virtual machine. This will not display anything on screen, so enter it carefully. Now you logged in to your virtual machine. You can verify it from Azure portal. Type command sudo apt update to update repository list. How to install Azure CLI. Refer Azure CLI installation video link given in description and click on I button on top right corner. Here in short to install Azure CLI in your Ubuntu VM in Azure Cloud, use below bash command to install it. How to create Azure Service Principal and what is its importance? An Azure Service Principal is an identity created for use with applications, hosted services, and automated tools to access Azure resources. This access is restricted by the roles assigned to the Service Principal, giving you control over which resources can be accessed and at which level. What is Service Principal used for? A Service Principal is created in each tenant where the application is used and references the globally unique app object. The Service Principal object defines what the app can actually do in the specific tenant, who can access the app, and what resources the app can access. Let us create Azure Service Principal, SPN, with role-based access control, RBAC, through Azure Bash Terminal. This is the simple command for creation of Service Principal. AZ, AD, SP, create -for -RBAC -N, my SPN. If you run above command, the SPN have now contributor role over your subscription. This can be verified by checking your Azure subscription from portal, under Access Control, IAM, Role Assignments. But our target is not to give that much permission to this service principle, so we use this command with in other way as below. To reduce your risk of a compromised service principle, use --skip-assignment to avoid creating a role assignment, then assign a more specific role and narrow the scope to a resource or resource group. Let's first create the MySPN with no assignments and no roles. AZADSP create --rbac-n --MySPN --skip-assignment. Later we'll need the SPN credentials. To make it easier to get these, we'll use environment variables. SPN equals dollar, AZADSP create --rbac-n, mySPN, --skip-assignment-ojson. Then let's display the credentials using JQ tool, which is already installed in Azure Cloud Shell. To display the SPN and to extract some specific fields like app id. Echo $SPN pipeline JQ. Echo $SPN pipeline JQ pipeline R single quotes dot app ID single quotes. We can assign roles to the service principal either using the Azure portal or using the Azure CLI. The first solution is, from the Azure portal, you can navigate to your resource group, then Access Control, IAM, Role Assignments, and then you can assign a role, like Reader, to your SPN. The second solution is, using command line. As we have already created a resource group as Learning Docker with interface, we will assign that. Scope equals --subscription/your-subscription-id/resource-group/resource-group-name-. Then we use the resource group to assign role contributor for the SPN. AZ role assignment create --role-contributor/--assignee-. Echo $SPN pipeline JQ-r --app-id-. --scope-scope. Now you can check the access control, IAM, in your resource group from Azure portal. Note that you can also create a service principal with role contributor and assign the role to multiple resources like two resource groups at once. AZADSP create --rbac-n--MySPN --role-contributor-scopes-subscriptions-subscription-id-resource-groups-resource-group-1-subscriptions-subscription-id-resource-groups-resource-group-2. Note that also you can use the parameter --years as number of years for which the credentials will be valid. Default value is 1 year if you don't give values. Azure users typically uses their identity, email and password, to connect to Azure. But machines, like DevOps build agents, will use the SPN login to Azure using SPN, AZ login-service-principal-username-. Echo $SPN pipeline JQ-r --app-id-. --password-. Echo $SPN pipeline JQ-r --password-. --tenant-. Echo $SPN pipeline JQ-r --tenant-. Login from virtual machine in Azure to Azure Cloud using Azure Service Principal. Steps to login. Open your git bash and paste command as below syntax. AZ login-service-principal-username-app-id-password-password-of-app-id-tenant-tenant-id of your subscription. Now if we try to get the resource groups, we'll see only the one with SPN assigned use below command az group list hyphen o table. To log in back to Azure CLI using your personal identity, just use az login. Finally, we'll got to delete the SPN we used here. azadsp:--id$echo$spn-pipeline-jq-r --apt-id-. Hope you have learned and understand the topic. Please like, share, subscribe and express your views and comment for our motivation. Thanks for watching.